Oh, no dialogue? Alright. I assume that that is the Seraphine Keep back there, but we're not interested in that anymore. We're on our way to the Pillars of Nazgûl. During the time for, whoa. Okay. This is a time for the corruption. This is round about a little while after the circle members have been killed by Corridor. So it's we're essentially hold on. About a little bit after the time that Soul Reaver 2 had ended it as far as Kane's storyline is concerned. Raziel had been drawn into the spectral realm, and he was in there for 500 years. That's why Raziel's further in the future than Kane is, because he didn't get out until that point. So a lot of the characters from the series here are either dead at the moment or not been born yet.
How strange to see this place long before my birth. Centuries before the corruption set in that would poison the land and put me on the treacherous path I still followed. In the future, these edifices would be condemned to darkness and decay. I would cause their fall and build my empire upon their ruins. Was it still possible that with the right knowledge, the right moves, I might one day see Nosgoth restored, the pillars pure once more? My answer, according to Mobius, lay somewhere to the west of this place. I could restore the world, perhaps, but never again could I give Nosgoth back her innocence.
Well, that is a hell of a thing. The Pillars of Nosgoth, basically, you could call them the central pillars of this game series. Each pillar has a guardian, and at the moment, the guardians that they've had for some time have been slain. With the exception of the Guardian of Death, the One of Time, and I imagine this is also, one of these is also the Guardian of Power or something like that, and that would be... So the three Circle members who have survived are Malik, the leader of the Seraphine, Mobius, the Time Streamer, the guy that we ran into back a few episodes ago in the tower, and Hortanius, the Necromancer, the one who eventually came and resurrected Kane after, as a vampire after he had been murdered. Very nice to be able to do that without shifting into the spectral plane. Now, Kane wants to go and restore Nosgoth because he knows. Sons of bitches. Everywhere I look, there's more bastards. Oh, how dare you! I can kill you last, buddy. I like that shit. Well, anyway, Kane wants to go and restore Nosgoth because, like, if you know the series, you know what eventually becomes of Nosgoth in the future in the Soul Reaver series. Nosgoth gets poisoned, gets ruined, almost. His population gets turned into vampires. That's horrible, horrible fate, and even Kane, the one who pretty much causes this to happen, its remorseful effort. Any more? Oh, yes. But it really wasn't just Kane to cause it. I mean, he was the one that he now has come to the understanding that nobody really makes major decisions in the world. All the reality and the way that timelines play out are as a result of pure fate. To die up there. Ah, shit. Platforming in this game is not too good. Ah, you fuckers. Oh, I can murder you like a... It's actually probably not the best way to go about this. Okay, you know what? I'm going the other way. There we go. Fate is essentially set, and there are kind of weird roundabout ways to change. But Kane was always fated to make the decision that he did, condemn the pillars to collapse, and all that kind of crap. Ah, you fuck. So in a certain way, you can say it wasn't really his fault, but it still weighs on him, you know. And now, son of a bitch, this damn camera system is terrible. Guy came out of nowhere. Just grab a hold of it and stay on top of it. Don't fall off the side. Not these guys, they can crawl off the side all they want. But Kane, Mobius seems to be pretty intent. Damn, did the camera angle change? Mobius seems pretty intent on informing Kane that. Like, no, you don't really... No, it didn't... Oh, son of a bitch. Mobius has a better understanding of the timeline than Kane does. Kane's knowledge of the future comes pretty much from his seeing the portals and stuff that Mobius had after Mobius died. Cutscene.
My path ended here. Offering only this empty vista... Was this another of Mobius's little jokes? Or a puzzle for which I had not yet found the answer? This symbol seemed familiar. Perhaps I needed to recover another fragment of the Balance Emblem before I could proceed.
Kane doesn't really have the understanding of how to manipulate history as well as Mobius did. Now, Mobius being a time stream and all that kind of crap, he knew what was going to happen before it happened. He knew his eventual death at the hands of Kane back in the day. Starting the war against the vampires and all that kind of stuff. Bastards. Are you dead? Yes. Let's jump in line, quick. Button down. So Mobius seems to have been basically manipulating the situation the entire time. Kane is trying to change the past, but I mean, he may not really know how to do it. In fact, restoring the pillars, he may not even be aware. But restoring the pillars may not actually restore Nazgûl. The way the Elder God had said it. The Elder God implied that the pillars collapsed and had something to do with the downfall of Nazgûl, with why it ended up turning shit the way it did. Somewhere in town. Yeah, whatever. Nice. But that may not have anything to do with it. As we found out in the past few weeks, Raziel's portion of this game, things were actually constructed as sort of a way of keeping the Hilden out of Nazgûl, out of this dimension. So their restoration may not actually yield any results. Then again, after the pillars collapsing and stuff, didn't result in the Hilden returning in the Soul Reaver timeline. But in the changed timeline that the combination of this game and Soul Reaver 2 resulted in, did so. Perhaps Kane has yet to make yet another mistake that will yield their return. Anyway, we have the thing we're looking for. We don't have the thing yet. This is about where we had started. But there's a puzzle over here to do. I guess we should have done it earlier. Again, perhaps I'm just not giving Kane the credit that he deserves, and he has something deeper in mind, you know? Haha, I can put that fire up. Oh, there's another one of these.
Fragment of the Balance Emblem. This one endowed with the properties of dimension. Perhaps this would reveal the mystery that lay west of the pillars, if Mobius spoke the truth, and there was indeed something there to find.
Properties of dimension? What the hell is that? Apparently I can't get up there to open that. Whatever. Oh, jig. Now we can go back to that balance. Wow. Shall we? Bastards are everywhere. Okay.
The mist that shrouded this lake miraculously now cleared away, revealing an ancient citadel. So Mobius had not lied. Or perhaps this was simply another of the Time Streamer's illusions meant to slow my true endeavor.
You're gonna die, bitch. Go.